So we already have a student class, and this student class is mapped to the students table here within the school database. So you can see we've got the following students, and this is the SQL to get the result over here. So now we want to add another table for teachers, but all we want to do is currently the students table here is named same as the class. So if I go over to the Visual Studio Code window over here, and you can see we have student over here. But what if we wanted another table called staff in the back end, but within the Visual Studio Code, we wanted to call it teacher rather than staff. So in the back end database, this would be staff, and in the Visual Studio Code, it would be teacher. What you can use is you can use a table annotation here and provide a table name. So this will link in with a table name called staff in the back end. In order to use the annotation, you need to include this over here. So what this will allow you to do is use the schema annotation, which is where the table annotation comes from. So if you were to remove this line over here, then VS Code will complain to say this namespace table attribute could not be found. You're missing namespace. So that's why at the beginning here, so you can see data annotation, but you need to add in data annotation dot schema. And this is where the table annotation lives. So this is going to have the same columns as the student table. So we will just leave them in this example as they are. So next we need to add in within the DB context, the teacher class over here as a table. So we will copy this and simply change Mr. Teacher. So then we're going to save this, and then we're going to create a migration. So here we're going to run this migration to add teacher staff table, and you can see the build started and build succeeded. So now if we have a look at our migrations over here in the migration folder, we should see teacher staff table. So what you can see here is create table, and notice the table name is called staff. Now this is important because we've called it that, although in C# we called a teacher as the class name, but in behind the scenes in the database, we want this table to be called staff. So that's what it will add. So at the minute, the change hasn't been applied to the database. We need to run one more command to apply the change to the database to get a new table. So we're going to run this command to simply update the database. So it's .NET EF database update. And the command is running, and that's succeeded. So now if we have a look at our database, so I'm going to refresh the tables over here. So come over to tables, and then I'm going to click this refresh button. And you can see there's now a table called staff. And if I do a top 1000 rows, you can see it's empty at the minute, no records. So you can see the table has been named staff over here, while in the code, we've called a teacher just by using the data annotation table, which you need also to reference from this using statement. So this comes from data annotation dot schema. So that's important to understand. It's within this namespace. And that basically allows you to have a different table name in the backend database versus what you have in your C# code for the class name. So teacher and then staff. This is how you map if you have different names. And you can do the same thing with columns by just changing the annotation here to column and then putting it on top of a column such as here, such as name. Then you can change the field name it maps to behind the scene in the database. So in this instance, we'll just change it back to the table. So this teacher class maps to the staff database table. So you can have different names in the backend versus what you have in the front end.